Good day, good people, and welcome back to the channel. In just a few moments, you'll get to hear my review and recap of episode 4 for Naked and Afraid of Love. But before I get started, if you're feeling this video, then feel free to hit the like button and even leave a comment below to let me know what you think about the show or this video. But without further delay, let's jump right in. This episode opens up with Castellay making her way towards the new group, and along in her journey, she shares her feelings about Jay while conceding that she needed to explore other options. Once Castellay arrives in the new group, the participants initially seem excited to see her, but they're also shocked that she came by herself. Castellay, in a roundabout way, tells the group why she came by herself, and they welcome her with open arms. Barak and Stefan are the first participants to share that they are attracted to Castellay, but in the back of my mind, I'm wondering how they would react to the news that she has a kid. Later on in the episode, the group is talking near a campfire, and Castellay seems impressed by the vibes that she's getting from the group. One of the comments that Castellay makes is that how she feels Stefan and Jay have much in common, which I took one of two ways. Either Castellay was attracted to Stefan, or she's unable to get over Jay. After that scene, all of the women in the group meet and talk about their connections with the men. Rachel seems to believe that she has a connection with Michael, which is pretty strong. Chelsea also likes her connection with Barak, but shared that she wanted to keep things open. And that statement is important to remember because I will come back to it in a little bit. During this discussion, Stefan interrupts the group and asks Lauren to go out on a date with him. Lauren agrees, which causes Ariel to immediately become jealous. Ariel's inner ugliness rears its head as she complains about how she likes Stefan since day one, but he's never asked her out on a date. Let's keep it real. Ariel is a beautiful girl, but her personality and knack for being possessive does appear to be off-putting, and I don't see her forming a connection with any of the other guys on the island unless she softens her approach. As Stefan and Lauren are on their date, they make sandcastles together and they engage in productive yet boring conversation. At this time, Stefan and Lauren seem to have a good connection, and I had high hopes for them to make it official. Later in the scene, Barak asks Castellay out on a date, and she agrees to go out with him. Barak planned out a very thoughtful and intimate date, which seemed to be very intriguing to Castellay. But nosy Chelsea decided to spy on Barak's date from a distance, and she got in her feelings. Chelsea expressed how she was displeased that Barak would ask Castellay out on a date, despite the connection that she and Barak had. Chelsea, you said it yourself. You wanted to keep things open. You also shared that you have very limited experiences in men, and you nearly got lost in the sunken place when Barak kissed you. You're extremely physically attractive, but that personality is an erection killer for sure. Later we see a scene with Stefan and Mike talking alone. Mike makes it known that he is not having any connection with any of the girls on the island, which is funny because Stefan shares the same thoughts. Barak later joins their conversation and reveals that the chemistry he had with Chelsea isn't there, and Castellay isn't really feeling him either. The group ultimately decides to relocate to another island. Prior to leaving, Ariel expresses her sadness that Stefan isn't really feeling her, and she becomes open to the possibility of finding another connection with someone else. Now let's move on to the second group. The episode opens up with a scene featuring Nelson and Jay. Jay is shown playing with jellyfish instead of doing something more productive, which is pretty much a reflection on his time at the island. So Jay and Nelson talk about Castellay leaving the group, and during this time, Jay seems passive-aggressive about his feelings towards Castellay. In my opinion, out of all the women on the island, Castellay was probably the best for Jay. However, he allowed his feelings about her having a kid to get in the way of things. And in a way, this is a reflection of how people in society will completely overlook a potential husband or wife due to superficial standards that they possess. Bennett and Candace have their alone time together, and they use this time to talk about Bennett's connection with Britt. Candace is shown coaching Bennett on how to get Britt. We then see Candace and Britt having a one-on-one conversation, and the topic shifts to how Jay ghosted Candace after their first date. Candace then suggests that Britt go on a date with Jay, and Bennett joins the conversation. Now before I move on, I must say that I respect Candace for trying to be the voice of reason and not trying to screw over the other women on the show just to get matched with a guy. but when Bennett joins the group, he encourages Candace to ask Jay out for two reasons. One, he realizes that Candace still likes Jay, and two, he needs Jay out of the picture so he can swoop in and get back with Britt. Well, Jay finally joins the group, and before Candace can ask him out, Jay asks out Britt and is a shock to everyone there. Britt agrees to go out on a date with him, but also voices to Candace how she doesn't like to be surprised like that. So we go back to Jay and we see him preparing for an elaborate date with Britt, much like he did with Cassilet and Candace. Fellas, especially the young bucks that are listening to this video, please listen carefully. Women talk, especially in small settings and when they know you're trying to date all of them. Jay is moving entirely too hard in the paint, too fast, which is causing these women to catch feelings for Jay while he knows he's not quite there yet. As a result, a person like Jay will develop a reputation for being a player, and it will be hard for him to make connections with other women. Fellas, please don't be like Jay, but I digress. Later on, Crystal and Britt share a scene together and concur that they need to meet new people. And to my surprise, Crystal opens up about being sexually fluid and having a crush on Candace. Britt encourages Crystal to shoot her shot with Candace, and the rest is history. Candace and Crystal agree to go on a date with one another. We see Jay going on his date with Britt, and he sets up a makeshift spa to give Britt a sensual massage. The problem is that this date is in viewing distance of the rest of the group, which causes Bennett to get in his feelings. At the conclusion of this date, Bennett approaches Britt for a one-on-one, and who would have thought, after Jay's elaborate date with Britt, she decides to friendzone him due to his lack of emotional intelligence. And while Bennett is back in the picture, Britt isn't quite ready to make things official with him yet. Later on in the episode, the group decides to migrate to the new island that the first group already migrated to. That is, everyone except Crystal and Candace. Crystal and Candace stay behind and get some quality time together. The episode ends with the four remaining members of the group arriving at the new island that the first group sees them from a distance. Now, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would rate this episode a 5. While it was nice to see some surprises, such as the Crystal and Candace connection, I express once more again that most of these people will not find a love connection on the island, or have the wherewithal to fake the connection with someone for the sake of the show. I can see at least 4 people tapping out within the next few episodes. Well, this concludes my review. Feel free to let me know your thoughts and feelings on the show and my video in the comment section, and I'll be sure to reply. And until next time, stay tuned and stay safe. Peace.